Hi. In this video, you will learn how to take your pictures and make a photo mosaic like this using the Turbo Mosaic software. You can get Turbo Mosaic from the link in the description. Let's get started. Open Turbo Mosaic and select an output size. For this example, we will use 48 inches by 36 inches. Before we go any further, we need to decide on a main picture to use for the mosaic. Here's an example of a photo mosaic and the corresponding main picture. The main picture is the one we're trying to create from other images. Click here to select the main picture. We'll actually crop this picture to focus on the couple's faces. Now we can add tile pictures to our mosaic. You can add as many tile pictures as you want, but a large number of tile pictures with a broad range of colors works best. Once those have loaded, we can generate our mosaic. We can even zoom in to see how the tile pictures are placed. Let's export our mosaic and take a look at the completed product. Excellent! And if we zoom in, we can still clearly see the individual tile images. Take a quick look at this photo mosaic. Notice the hexagonal tiles. Make sure you stick around until the end of the video to see how you can create a photo mosaic like this. Let's go back to our original photo mosaic and take a look at some of the other tools Turbo Mosaic has to offer. You can crop any mosaic tile just by clicking on it and selecting the crop tool. You can drag a picture from the pictures pane into a tile. You can easily exchange pictures into tiles. By default, the photo mosaic uses square tiles. You can adjust the cell size setting to use rectangular cells. Here's a sample mosaic that uses rectangular cells in a 3:2 aspect ratio. By default, the pictures are joined together. Use this slider to adjust the spacing between tiles. We can also set a color to fill this space between tiles. The default color is black, but we can switch it to white. By clicking here, we can set the main picture to appear through the space in between tiles. Notice how the tiles are placed in front of the main picture, which shows through the space between the tiles. Some of the tiles in the photo mosaic may not match the main picture well, so colorization tints these tiles to match the main picture better. We can use this slider to make adjustments to that. There is also a control to partially display the main picture in front of the mosaic. This makes the mosaic look more like the main picture. We can use this slider to make adjustments to that. Now let's talk about the cell mirroring setting. Here's a zoomed mosaic. Notice the two highlighted tiles. They are the same picture mirrored left to right. The cell mirroring option allows using the original tile picture or its mirror image, whichever matches better. If you turn it off, only the original tile picture will be used. It's also important to understand the duplicate spacing setting. Here's a mosaic with a duplicate spacing set to 0. This means that the same tile picture can be used next to each other, like the coffee mug picture here. Here's another mosaic with a duplicate spacing set to 2. Notice the coffee mug picture has at least two different pictures in between. To wrap up the video, we will go over creating photo mosaics with different shape cell styles. We'll do the diamond shape first. Just click the cell style drop-down menu and select diamond. Then we will need to regenerate the mosaic. Let's zoom in to look at the newly generated mosaic. Next, we can switch to the circular cell style, generate the mosaic, and when we zoom in, we can see the circular shaped tiles. And finally, as promised, we're going to create a mosaic with the hexagonal cell style. We can generate the mosaic, and then zoom in to take a closer look at the hexagonal tiles that make up our newest mosaic. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel for more photo collage and mosaic making videos.